Hello and welcome to the channel. Join us for the next few days in bringing this Mark II Range Rover from 2001 back to life. This vehicle was in everyday service up until the pandemic. During the pandemic, when not a lot of people could move about, we decided to park this vehicle. So it was left for a year, and we went to it after the pandemic to put it back into service. And we pulled the dipstick out, and the oil pan was full of coolant. So we drained all that out and got that sorted, and we got her fired up. And she sounded good, but we soon realized that the coolant system was being pressurized. After some diagnostics, the result from that was it had a slipped cylinder liner, which is not an uncommon thing on the Rover V8, especially the later ones that did suffer from slipped liners. We had two options. Option one was to completely rebuild the original engine, which would be several thousand pounds. The other option was to get an engine that has already been worked and rebuilt, and we found one. 30,000 miles ago, the engine that we have has been rebuilt. So all we have to do now is do an engine transplant.
Turn it over until the bolts for the torque converter line up with the little hole that I'm working through.
Right, okay.
All right, so yes. Listen to what I'm saying.
I'll listen. I will follow. And I'm turning it to the right.
Well, it only go one way.
Right, okay.
Right, I don't even know what size socket it is. Turn it slowly.
Okay.
Right, hold
just go back slightly.
I can't.
You'll have to turn the little lever.
Turn the little lever.
On the ratchet.
Got a little lever. Oh, that little thing. Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
And I want you to slightly go back.
Like that?
Go on. Right, yeah, that's how it feels. Right, a bit more. Go on. Not moving.
Well, I'm turned. I've now reached the end of my turn. Okay.
Not moving.
Well, this is.
Is it slipping on the pull?
Yes.
Right, turn it back the other way. We'll go for the next bolt.
Right, okay. So put my lever back.
Yep.
Yep.
Looks like the engine, it'll only want to turn one way. It'll be on the compression.
So. Right, okay.
Right, so you go. No, you go that way. There you go.
Right, so now I'm coming back to the left.
Go on. Hang on, let me put my finger in and everything. Right. Go on, move it slower. Yeah, it's not easy this to work on. Looking forward to putting it together tomorrow.
Going to tape this bolt onto the socket, because if that bolt falls off, it'll be inside the bell housing, which is not where I want it. And we're going to feed it through that little plate that's only about 1.5 inch diameter.
water in the coolant. We'll just check the dipstick out. Plenty of oil in there. Let's turn the key and see what happens. Life support. Hello and welcome back. Yesterday we had the V8 running. All was good until it got up to temperature. And we had like boiling out of the expansion tank. Now that could be a head gasket. But what we think it was a thermostat. This is the thermostat for this engine. Now we were boiling over. The temperature gauge on the dash was saying everything was fine. But the radiator was cold. Half the thermostat was cold. That was telling me the thermostat wasn't opening to circulate the water. So all that was happening was the water was just going around the engine and it was boiling it up. We put this thermostat in a pan in the kitchen this morning and we got the pan up to boiling temperature and the thermostat didn't move. So that thermostat, that's toast. We've changed the thermostat. We've had this thermostat that's on the engine now in a pan and it opened fine. So let's get the engine running. Let's crank her up and let's see what happens. There's something about an old Range Rover. I don't quite know what it is.
you all right?
I fell in the hedge. Somebody, get rid of this dog.
Oh, Teddy, come on.
Get rid of this dog. Teddy, back.